Good morning. So in yesterday's lecture, we discussed about one type of classification. That is, the repertories are classified into five groups. First one is general, then clinical repertories, then card repertories, mechanically aided repertories, and drug-oriented repertories. So in general repertory, it was again classified, subclassified into two groups based on concept of general to particular, and the second subclassification is based on concept of particular to general. So in the first classification, it was, the example was Kent's repertory, and in the second classification, the example was BBCR. Then clinical repertories, it was again classified into two groups covering the whole person. These are also called as general repertory of body, and Clark's repertorium generale, which is in 6 volume. Then covering the region, the second clinical repertories classification is covering the region. So it was again subclassified into three groups, that is based on parts, based on system, and based on disease. So the first subclassification based on part means it was related to one part of the body. So the example was repertory of eyes. Then based on system, the example was repertories on respiratory or digestive system. Then based on disease condition, the examples of Bell's diarrhea or based on many respiratory and diarrhea conditions, there are many repertories. Then card repertory, the third classification of repertories is card repertories. The example of these, there are several cards of these repertory. The examples are Jugal Kishore's card repertory, Sharma's card repertory, P. Shankaran's card repertory. Then mechanically aided repertories, in that auto-visual repertory, Patel's auto-visual repertory. Then computer repertories, all computer repertories. Then drug-oriented repertory, that is the repertory of Powell Nosu. So this classification we discuss in detail in the last lecture. So there are, according to different homeopaths, as we discussed yesterday, the classification, they have classified the repertories according to their own way. So this was one type of classification. Then second type of classification of repertories are general repertories, special repertories, and mechanically aided repertory. So in general repertory, repertory of antisuric medicine, concordance, thematic repertory, and alphabetical repertory, they came under the first classification, that is general repertory. Then special repertories, they are classified into two groups, organ wise and clinical. The clinical repertories covering the whole person and disease wise, and mechanically aided repertories, these are card repertory and softwares. So the general repertories, these are the repertories which contain all the symptoms of all the parts and body as a whole. That means in these repertory, it contain mental symptoms, mental general symptoms, physical general symptoms, as well as particulars. It means while compiling these repertories, person as a whole was considered. So while compiling these repertory, the whole person, all symptoms from his mental state to physical, general as well as particular state, all things we have to consider. Then in general repertories, the sub-classification or the repertories which include under general repertories are alphabetical repertories. The name itself indicates how the symptoms are arranged in this repertory. So the symptoms in these repertories, they are arranged in a alphabetical order. These repertories are qualifying as general repertories to a reference book. For example, chapter wise repertory, which is the example, the Murphy's repertory is the example of this chapter wise repertory. Then rubric wise repertory, so the example of this rubric wise repertory are Phatak's repertory, Srivastava's repertory, Allen's symptom register. So these are the example of rubric wise repertory. So in alphabetical repertory, there are two subgroups, that is chapter wise and rubric wise. Under chapter wise, Murphy's repertory, and under rubric wise, Phatak's repertory, Srivastava's repertory, and Allen's symptom register came under the rubric wise repertories. Then the next classification under general repertories is thematic repertory. So according to its name, there was some theme so that we can able to know what is the exact problem of the patient. So this repertory was written by Jose Antonio Merilli, realizing that the mental state of the patient is important for the selection of drug. This repertory had been published. This repertory is based on themes, for example, J.A. Merilli's thematic repertory. So these repertories, they are based on themes. So Merilli's thematic repertory is its classification. So this is about the second type of classification. Then third type of classification, the modern repertories, they are classified into two groups. First one is alphabetical repertory. Under alphabetical repertory, as we discussed, the Phatak repertory and Murphy's repertory are the examples of alphabetical repertory. Then anatomical repertories. So the examples of these anatomical repertories are complete repertory and synthesis repertory. So these are the example of anatomical repertory. Then other levels of classification based on overall appearances, based on internal formatting, and based on group characteristics. So how the in other way the repertories we may classify, or we can able to classify or group the repertories into different parts or different groups, how we can separate. So according to their overall appearance, according to their internal formatting, how they are constructed, how they are planned, then based on group characteristics, what are the characteristics of these repertories, what is the basic concept behind these repertories. So this is the one other way of classification of repertories into different groups. So based on overall appearance, these are book repertories, card repertories, and software packages. So how these repertory appear, what is the appearance of these repertory? So these repertories may be book in the form of book, they are grouped under the book repertories. Some repertories are in the form of cards, as we have studied earlier, card repertories. So some repertories are in the form of cards, so they group under card repertories, and some repertories they are in the form of softwares. In the mechanically, some repertories they are mechanically aided, so they came under software packages. In this way, according to the appearance of the repertory, the repertories are grouped into three groups. Then, based on internal formatting, how these repertories are formatted, how the formation or how these repertories are constructed. The Puritan group, as we already discussed about the Puritan group, the Puritan repertories, these are written in the pure language of the poor, so these are called as Puritan repertories. The example of these repertories are Calvin's, Dr. Calvin B. Nance's repertory of Herring's guiding symptoms of our Materia Medica. So this is the example. Then other, that is Gentry's concordance repertory, which is in 6 volumes. So in this way, the Nair's repertory and Gentry's concordance repertory, these are the repertories which came under Puritan group. In these repertories, as we studied earlier, that in these repertories we are not used for the purpose of proper repertorization, but these repertories are only for only used for the purpose of reference. So these repertories are called as Puritan group of repertory. Then logical utilitarian group. So many times on this logical utilitarian group, there was a short note asked in previous examination. So what is the logical utilitarian group of repertories? So the arrangement in these repertories and their utility value, they have their own distinct principles. These repertories, logical utilitarian group of repertories, they have their own arrangement and they have their own utility value, their own principles. And in these, this type of repertories, the symptoms may not be found in the language of Materia Medica, but the symptoms which we found in these repertories, they are in the form of repertorial, in the repertorial language, or in this repertory we change the symptom, we found the symptoms which are changed which we found the symptoms get changed their form to fit into the arrangement of the repertory. So as the symptoms they are logically arranged as the symptoms, their arrangement, their utility value, and as they each repertory which came under this logical utilitarian group, they have their own arrangement, their own utility value, and their own distinct principle. So these repertories are called as logical utilitarian group of repertories. The examples of these type of repertories are Dr. Boning Hussain's therapeutic pocket book, repertory of homeopathic materia medica by Dr. J. T. Kent, and Lippe's repertory by Dr. Constantine Lippe. So these are the example of this group. Because Boning, we know about all these repertories under in Boning Hussain's therapeutic pocket book. It was having its own principles. The Kent repertory, that is complete symptom. Then Kent repertory, it was having its own principles that give the importance first to mentals, then we should go towards the particulars. Then Lippe's repertory, so it is also having the same principles as that of the Kent's repertory, and they have their own plan of construction. So these repertory, these are the examples of this logical utilitarian group of repertories. So there are many times short note asked in previous examinations on Puritan group of repertory as well as on logical utilitarian group of repertory. So you should know what is Puritan group of repertory and what is logical utilitarian group of repertory and which are the examples of these both groups. Then the other another classification of repertories is repertories based on group characteristics. So which are these repertories which are based on group characteristics? These are general repertories, regional repertories, alphabetical repertories, then concordance repertories, card repertories, and computer repertories. According to their group characteristics, the repertories, they are classified into these six groups, that is general, regional, alphabetical, concordance, card, and computer repertories. What are particular repertories? These repertories are based on clinical orientation, focused on certain particular states or particular diseased condition. A specific state may be a modifying factor. It affords a high degree of specification in the particular area. So the particular repertories, these are mostly the clinical repertories. They have the clinical rubrics which we found in these repertories, and they are in these repertories we found they are based on a particular part or particular disease condition. So these repertories are named as particular repertories. So these repertories are based on clinical orientation, focused on certain particular states or particular diseased condition. The specific state may be a modifying factor. It affords a high degree of specification in the particular area, for example, time modalities by Sheth PV, diarrhea by James Webb. So these are the examples of particular repertories which affect on a particular area or affect on particular clinical condition. In particular clinical condition, we can use these type of repertories. Then comparative repertories. This is one of the latest repertories. It helps in differentiating the medicines within the rubric. For example, comparative repertory by Knox and Ocklenberg. So these are the latest repertories, and in differentiating the medicine, these repertories are especially useful in during differentiation purpose. So this is again one different classification, that is comparative repertory. The next classification or next group of repertories is pathogenic repertories. This is an index to symptoms as presented during the drug proving. These pathogenic repertories, these are nothing but the index to the symptoms as presented during the drug proving. It is useful when the pathological changes and objective symptoms form the only available database in the case. For example, repertory of drug pathogenicity by Richard Hughes. So these pathogenic repertories, they are nothing but index to the symptoms which are presented during the drug proving. And mostly these type of symptoms, they are useful when the pathological changes and objective symptoms form the only available database in the case. The example is repertory of drug pathogenicity by Richard Hughes. Then the next classification of the repertories is next group of repertories is reference repertories. These are not repertories in strict sense, but these books are handy for prescribing in acute cases and in cases with insufficient data. So when there is insufficient data, at that time these repertories, these reference repertories, we can refer these repertories, and these are not the repertories proper, these are not the strict repertories, but these are handy books especially prescribe the medicine in acute condition, in acute cases when there is insufficient data. The example of these reference repertories or these books, the example is Quick Bedside Prescriber by Single. So the Single's Quick Bedside Prescriber, this is the book or this is the repertory which is called as a reference repertory, especially used in acute cases, prescribing in acute cases, when we have the insufficient data. In these conditions, these type of remedies they are useful. Then therapeutic digest. These are miniature versions of repertories and deals mainly with a particular clinical condition. So in these type of repertories, we found a particular clinical condition and for that clinical condition, we found the related remedies or indicated remedies which are mentioned. So these are nothing but the therapeutic repertories or therapeutic books, also we called. These are miniature version of repertories and deals mainly with particular clinical condition. And the example is Rao's special. Example is Rao's special pathology and therapeutic hymns. So this is the example of this therapeutic digest. Then what is the use and what is the importance of different groups of repertories? How the grouping of repertories, how this classification of repertories, it was useful, is it useful or not? So the uses and importance of different groups of repertories, which are the uses? So first, general repertories. These are useful general repertories. They are mostly useful for the purpose of individualization according to the principle of homeopathy. So in these general repertory, as we know, it covers the whole person, it covers the all parts, all systems, all organs of the person, and it also covers the all states, that is mental general state, physical general state, as well as particular state of the person. So these general repertories, they are used for purpose of individualization according to the principles of homeopathy. Then card repertories. Before card repertories, there are so many repertories, but to convert the rubrics, to find all these rubrics, to make the totality, to analyze, evaluate, then to make totality, then found each rubric in the repertory, and then repertorize properly the case with pen, paperwork, or by writing down the indicated number of marks in front of that medicine, then counting those marks, and then you get finally the group of indicated remedies. So when we get the group of indicated remedy, then with the help of Materia Medica and with the help of other things, that is mental state, physical state, and some modalities, concomitants, we can find out the similimum. So this is the process to find out the similimum. But it was time consuming process. So many homeopaths, they make their own cards and they able so that we can, in short period, we can find out the similimum. This was the aim of these homeopaths, to write down these type of cards or diaries. So these card repertories, they are less time consuming, less laborious than that of actual paper and ink repertorization. It cuts down time needed in calculation of marks and analysis of repertorial result. It reduces eye strain by reducing the work of repertorization. It is very easy to handle. So these card repertories, these are less time consuming, as these repertories are less laborious than actual paper and ink repertorization. These repertories cut down time which is needed for proper calculation of marks and find out the simulimum. Then it also reduces the eye strain, reducing the work of repertorization, and very easy to handle. These are the uses of these card repertories, which we already discussed in card repertory also. Then computer repertories. So which are the uses of computer repertory, or which are the merits of computer repertory? We all know it saves a lot of time and concentrate only on the patient. So when we do the repertorization with pen paper, then it is time consuming, as well as we need there is need to write down everything. So it saves a lot of time, these computer repertories, it saves a lot of time and it concentrate only on patient. Search through materia medica for symptoms not found in repertory. Which symptoms we cannot found in repertory easily, can able to search these symptoms through materia medica in less time with the help of these computer repertories. Then to create data bank of cured cases and to be in contact via HomeoNet with homeopaths all over the world. It is an excellent tool to collect information and have it ready to display in teaching or therapy. These computer repertories, they are an excellent tool to collect the information and have it ready to display in teaching the therapy. Then they are used for ready reference. They create an impression on the patient. The number of options available for reference is immense, and the work is also very fast. May also carry to the bedside in the form of laptop. In this way, these repertories, these computer repertories, in these computer repertories there are number of options available for references. There are many repertories, we can use any repertory out of those. Then there are many materia medicas for reference purpose, and the work is very fast. May also carry it to the bedside in the form of laptop. So we can carry these type of softwares or these computer repertories very easily to the bedside in the form of laptop. So these are the merits of computer repertories. Then concordance repertories. concordance repertories, they are also called as Puritan repertories. Then the symptoms can be found out easily and saves a lot of time. It is a great manual to refer to any needed symptom, but not useful for systemic repertorization. As we all know, it is in pure language of patient, so it is also called as Puritan repertory. And these repertories, they are not used for proper repertorization, but it is very helpful to refer any needed symptom, especially while searching the rubric. We cannot get the rubric at that time,